Hello, welcome to the next session of basic surveying model number 2. In the last session, we had solved two problems related to local attractions. Now let us go to the next problem. Okay, so problem number 3 goes like this. The following are bearings taken on a closed traverse. Fore bearing of line AB is 80 degree 10 minutes and back bearing is 259 degrees 0 minutes. Line BC 120 degrees 20 minutes. 301 degrees 50 minutes. Line CD 170 degree 50 minutes. 350 degrees 50 minutes. Line DE 230 degrees 10 minutes and back bearing is 49 degree 30 minutes. Line EA 310 degrees 20 minutes and 130 degrees 15 minutes. So these are the bearings given, and compute the interior angles and correct them for observational errors. Assuming the observed bearing of the line CD to be correct, adjust the bearing of the remaining sides. So he has given you bearings of these lines. So if you observe the bearings, it has started from A and ended at A. What do you mean by this? This means it is a closed traverse. A and A, it is a closed traverse. Then you have to calculate the interior angles in this case. So by the bearings, you can easily calculate the interior angles. We know how to calculate it. Next, correct them for observational errors. The bearing of line CD given is correct according to the question. Adjust the bearing of the remaining sides. So in this case, you have to calculate the interior angles first, then check whether the sum of the angles will satisfy the check. If it doesn't satisfy, you have to apply some correction, and then you have to add all the interior angles, then check, then apply those corrections in the bearings. So by taking the bearing of the line CD as correct, as given in the data, we have to proceed further. I hope you have understood the problem. So let us move on to the solution. How do you calculate interior angles? Let me plot it for your convenience. A, first quadrant A to B, 80 degree 10 minutes, okay. Next, station B, back bearing is 259, next BC is 120, second quadrant, okay, this is station C. Next, fore bearing is 170 degrees 50 minutes, it is in the second quadrant itself. Then, fore bearing of line DE, 230 degrees. So it is lying in third quadrant. So D to station E. Next, then E to A is 310 degree 20 minutes, fourth quadrant. Yes, you can easily join. So this is your closed traverse. Okay. So you have to calculate the interior included angles. You have to calculate all these angles first, then check whether the sum of the angles satisfies the check. Okay, if doesn't satisfy, you have to apply the correction. You know, see, if you observe, these are nothing but your interior included angle, not exterior. So you have the check 2n minus 4 into 90. So how many sides do we have here? 1 2 3 4 5 sides are there here. So n is nothing but number of sides. So 2 into 5 minus 4, whole thing into 90 degrees will be equal to 10 minus 4 into 90, that is equal to 6 into 90, 540 degrees. So we should get the sum of the interior angles equal to 540 degrees. So let us check solution. How can we calculate angle A? How do you calculate angles, interior angles? Bearing of the previous line minus bearing of the next line. That is, bearing of previous line. Observe here, at A, bearing of previous line will be the back bearing AE, and minus 4 bearing of the next line will be bearing AB. That is equal to back bearing of A minus 4 bearing of AB. That is equal to back bearing of A is 130 degree 15 minutes minus 4 bearing of AB is 80 degree 10 minutes. That is equal to 50 degrees 5 minutes. Next, similarly, you can calculate angle B. This angle. So, how do you calculate it? Bearing of the previous line minus bearing of the next line. That is, back bearing of line BA minus 4 bearing of BC. Okay, that is equal to back bearing of BA. 259 degrees 0 minutes minus 4 bearing of BC, it is 120 degree 20 minutes, is equal to 138 degrees 40 minutes. So this is angle B. Next, how do you calculate angle C? Bearing of the previous line minus bearing of the next line. That is equal to angle C equals to back bearing of, if you observe the figure, you can easily write back bearing of this line is nothing but back bearing of CB minus 4 bearing of CD. That is equal to back bearing of CB 301 degrees 50 minutes minus 4 bearing of line CD, it is equal to 170 degrees 50 minutes. That is equal to 131 degrees 0 minutes. Okay, next let us calculate angle D. This angle is given by bearing of previous line minus bearing of next line. That is back bearing of line DC minus 4 bearing of DE is equal to back bearing of DC is 350 degrees 50 minutes minus 4 bearing of the next line, which is 230 degree 10 minutes. That is equal to 120 degrees 40 minutes. Okay, next angle E, the last angle. This is the angle. So, bearing of the previous line minus bearing of next line. That is equal to back bearing of ED minus 4 bearing of EA is equal to back bearing of ED is 49 degree 30 minutes minus 4 bearing of EA is 310 degree 20 minutes. So if you observe here, 49 degree 30 minutes minus 310 degree 20 minutes will give you a negative answer or negative value. So what we should do, if the interior angle is negative, you have to add 360 to it. If the angle is negative, you have to add 360 to it. So because you cannot measure a negative angle. So what you should do, if you observe this part, you will get a negative value. So add 360 degrees. That is equal to 99 degrees 10 minutes. Okay, so now let us take the sum of all the interior angles which you have calculated. Now angle A, angle B, angle C, This is angle D and angle E. So if you add all the angles, that is angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D, and angle E, you will get you'll get 539 degrees 35 minutes. Okay, but we have already calculated what is the correct sum of the angles, which is 540 degrees. But here we have obtained 539 degrees 35 minutes. So what you should do? You have to deduct this value from 540. Theoretical sum is equal to 540 degrees. But let us calculate the error. minus 539 degree 35 minutes. Let us calculate the error. That is equal to 539 degrees 35 minutes minus 540 degrees is equal to minus 25 minutes. Therefore, the correction to be applied should be equal to plus 25 minutes. This is the total correction to be applied for all the angles. Now, what about the individual angle? Since we are having 5 sides, you should divide this by 5, where 5 is what? Number of sides, which I have already written here. Okay, let me write n is equal to 5. So you have to divide this value by 5. That will give you 5 minutes correction at each angle. You have to add 5 minutes to each interior angle calculated. So, corrected angles. Corrected angles can be written as angle A is equal to 50 degree 10 minutes. Angle B 138 degrees 45 minutes. Angle C 131 degrees 5 minutes. Angle D 120 degrees 45 minutes. And angle E 99 degrees 15 minutes. Now, taking these corrected angles, you have to correct the bearings. How do you calculate bearings from angles? And he has mentioned that the bearing of the line CD is correct. So keeping that in mind and taking these angles, you have to calculate the remaining bearings. We shall calculate the correct bearings now. So let me write these values in the figure. That is, angle A is equal to 50 degree 10 minutes. Angle B is 138 degrees 45 minutes. Angle C 131 degrees 5 minutes. Angle D 120 degrees 45 minutes. And angle E 99 degrees 15 minutes. So these are our corrected interior angles. So, keeping those interior angles into consideration, we have to calculate the bearings. So, he has mentioned that the bearing of the line CD is correct. So, we have to start from this point. Okay, you have to start from this point and calculate all the other bearings. Now, starting with the correct bearing of CD, let us calculate the bearings of all other lines. That is, the first one will be 4 bearing of DE is equal to, see, keeping the bearing of line CD as correct, we have to calculate the bearing of the next line, that is forebearing of the line DE. How can you calculate the forebearing of the line DE? That is equal to back bearing of the previous line, back bearing of DC minus back bearing of DC minus angle D. That is equal to back bearing of DC is 350 degrees 50 minutes minus corrected angle is 120 degrees 45 minutes. Okay, that is equal to 230 degrees 5 minutes. Okay, if the forebearing of the line DE is 200 degree 5 minutes, what about its back bearing? ED is equal to, since this is more than 180, I have to deduct it from 180. 230 degree 5 minutes minus 180 degree is equal to 50 degrees 5 minutes. Okay, next let us calculate the forebearing of next line. After DE, we will calculate EA. That is equal to back bearing of the line DE or ED minus angle E. That is equal to, so what is the back bearing of the line ED? It is 50 degrees 5 minutes minus angle E 99 degree 15 minutes. Observe this. If you take the difference between these two, you will get minus value or negative value. So you have to add 360 degrees to it. That is equal to 310 degrees 50 minutes, the corrected bearing of line EA. What about its back bearing? Back bearing of AE is equal to, is it more than 180, less than 180? It is more than 180. So I have to deduct 180 from this value. That is equal to 130 degrees 50 minutes. Okay, next let's calculate forebearing of line AB is equal to back bearing of previous line, that is AE minus angle A. This is equal to back bearing of AE is 130 degrees 50 minutes minus angle A. That is equal to 80 degrees 40 minutes. Okay, so what about its back bearing? Back bearing of line BA is equal to, observe this value, this is less than 180, so add 180 to it. 80 degree 40 minutes plus 180 degrees will give you 260 degrees 40 minutes. Okay, next let's calculate the forebearing of next line BC is equal to back bearing of BA minus angle B should be equal to 260 degree 40 minutes minus angle B is 138 degrees 45 minutes. That is equal to 121 degrees 55 minutes. Okay, next let me calculate the back bearing of line CB is equal to, observe this value, this is less than 180, so add 180 to it. 121 degrees 55 minutes plus 180 degrees is equal to 301 degrees 55 minutes. Next, let us calculate the forebearing of next line, that is forebearing of line CD is equal to back bearing of CB minus angle C, that is equal to back bearing of CB is 301 degrees 55 minutes minus angle C is 131 degrees 5 minutes is equal to 170 degree 50 minutes. Now let us calculate its back bearing. Back bearing of DC is equal to, observe this value, is this less than 180? Yes, it is less than 180, so you have to add 180 to it. So 170 degrees 50 minutes plus 180 degrees is equal to 350 degrees 50 minutes. If you observe this value and the correct bearings given, take the bearing of the line CD as correct. It was mentioned in the question. So if you observe here, we have got the same value. So this is nothing but your check and it is satisfied. So interior angles and the corrections applied to it, and taking those corrections and applying to the bearings, we have calculated the correct bearings. So if you observe in this case, so we had solved a problem calculating bearings from angles. So there I had calculated the angles in an anti-clockwise direction. So I had used bearing of the previous line plus included angle will give you the bearing of the next line. But in this case, I am calculating the bearings in a clockwise direction. So I am using fore bearing of a line is equal to back bearing of the previous line minus the included angle. Okay. Next, let us move on to problems on declination. Previously, we have dealt with local attraction problems. Now, let us solve some declination problems. Okay. So the first problem is, the magnetic bearing of a line is 48 degrees 24 minutes. Calculate the true bearing if the magnetic declination is 5 degrees 38 minutes east. He has given the magnetic bearing of a line which is equal to 48 degrees 24 minutes. Okay. Next, calculate the true bearing if the magnetic declination is 5 degrees 38 minutes east. First, you need to write what is given. Okay. Then you should plot the bearing. Then we shall calculate the required true bearing. Okay. So, given magnetic bearing of a line. So, let me write magnetic bearing as MB of a line equal to 48 degrees 24 minutes. He has given magnetic declination. Five degrees 38 minutes east. You need to calculate what? True bearing. True bearing, or I can write TB. So you know what is declination? That is nothing but the angle made between the true meridian to the magnetic meridian. Right? This was explained earlier. What is given in the question? The magnetic bearing of a line is equal to 48 degree 24 minutes. One magnetic declination of 5 degree 38 minutes is given. So first let us plot it. Declination of 5 degrees 38 minutes is given towards east. So this is north. This is declination. Next, you should also plot the bearing. Okay? This is what? Actually, the true meridian, and this is what? The magnetic meridian. Plot the bearing with reference to magnetic meridian. So from this, whatever you plot will be your bearing, magnetic bearing, that is 48 degrees 24 minutes. Now if you need to calculate the true bearing, you should add these two angles. Okay, So this plus this bearing will give you the true bearing of the line. Let us calculate. True bearing is equal to declination plus the magnetic bearing. Okay, this is the formula to be used. That is equal to, that is accord, if you see the figure, you can easily understand. Declination is 5 degrees 38 minutes plus magnetic bearing is how much? 48 degrees 24 minutes. That is equal to 54 degrees 2 minutes is your true bearing. Okay. First, you need to plot the declination here. That is, declination is given as 5 degree 38 minutes towards east. So this is nothing but the magnetic meridian. This is the true meridian. So angle made between these two is nothing but the declination. Okay. If you look at this figure, you can easily write this and calculate the true bearing. Okay. Yes, now let us move on to the second problem. That is, the magnetic bearing of a line AB is south 28 degrees east. Calculate the true bearing if the declination is 7 degrees 30 minutes west. Okay. So let us write what is given. Magnetic bearing of line AB is south 28 degrees 30 minutes east. Okay. Next, declination is equal to 7 degrees 30 minutes west. Declination is 7 degrees 30 minutes west. Calculate its true bearing. To calculate true bearing, you have to plot the given declination and magnetic bearing. If this is the true meridian, you should plot the declination first. Declination is 7 degrees 30 minutes west. So this is west, east, south and north, which is the true meridian. Okay. Next, 7 degree 30 minutes west. 7 degrees 30 minutes west. You should plot that declination here. This is 7 degrees 30 minutes. What is this now? This is your magnetic meridian. This is your true meridian. This is your magnetic meridian. Okay. Next, what is given? The magnetic bearing of a line AB is given as south 28 degrees 30 minutes east. So let me take this as station A. South 28 degree 30 minutes east. It is expressed in reduced bearing system. So you should plot it here. 28 degree 30 minutes east is lying in the second quadrant. So given is your magnetic bearing of the line AB. That should be plotted with respect to your magnetic meridian. Okay. So what I will do, I will extend this line. I will extend this line and plot the magnetic bearing. Which is 28 degrees 30 minutes east. Okay. Next, coming to the declination, can I say this angle and this angle are same? If you observe this diagram, same. That is 7 degrees 30 minutes. So now what about the true bearing? If you observe the diagram, it is the summation of your declination to the magnetic bearing of the line. That is equal to declination plus magnetic bearing. That is equal to 7 degrees 30 minutes plus 28 degrees 30 minutes. That is equal to 36 degrees 0 minutes. So it is 36 degrees 0 minutes. Since it is expressed in quadrantal bearing system or reduced bearing system, we should write this true bearing in the same system, which is south 36 degree 0 minutes east is your true bearing. Understood? Let me move on to the next problem. So problem number 3. In an old map, a line AB was drawn to a magnetic bearing of 5 degree 30 minutes. Okay. In an old map, a line AB was drawn to a magnetic bearing of 5 degrees 30 minutes. Okay. Next. The magnetic declination at that time. See, very important. The magnetic declination at that time being 1 degree east. To what magnetic bearing should the line be set? To what magnetic bearing should the line be set? Now, if the present magnetic declination, is 8 degree 30 minutes east. If the present magnetic declination is 8 degree 30 minutes east. So, let us understand what is given in the problem. Given, what is given? Magnetic bearing of the line AB is equal to 5 degree 30 minutes and the magnetic declination was 1 degrees east and the declination was 1 degree east. See, he has specified magnetic bearing of a line AB along with the declination of the same line, which is 1 degree towards east. Okay. Now if you calculate its true bearing, what is the formula? True bearing is equal to declination plus magnetic bearing. That is equal to 1 degree plus 5 degrees 30 minutes. That is nothing but 6 degrees 30 minutes is the true bearing of line AB. This is nothing but true bearing of line AB. He has given one more declination, that is present declination. He has given you present declination, which is equal to 8 degrees 30 minutes east. 8 degrees 30 minutes east. To what magnetic bearing should the line be set now if the present magnetic declination is 8 degrees 30 minutes east? So now we know present declination is equal to 8 degrees 30 minutes. Let us plot it. Then we will understand easily. This is your true meridian. What is given? Declination 8 degree 30 minutes east. This is nothing but the magnetic meridian. And the declination 8 degrees 30 minutes. This is the declination given. Now, what do we know? We know the true bearing of the line AB. True bearing of the line AB. That is equal to how much? 6 degrees 30 minutes. True bearing of the line AB is equal to 6 degrees 30 minutes. So, we can plot it here. Okay. This is the true bearing. True bearing is equal to how much? 6 degrees 30 minutes. So what you need to calculate? You need to calculate magnetic bearing. Magnetic bearing is nothing but the angle made between the magnetic meridian to the true bearing. So the angle made between the magnetic meridian to the survey line given is nothing but your magnetic bearing. Next, let me calculate this magnetic bearing. Next, what do we know? We know the relation true bearing is equal to declination plus magnetic bearing. We know true bearing is given by declination plus magnetic bearing. What do you know? True bearing is known, declination is known, magnetic bearing is not known. We have to calculate this. So you can write magnetic bearing is equal to true bearing minus declination. Minus declination. Substitute. True bearing is equal to 6 degrees 30 minutes minus 8 degrees 30 minutes. That is equal to minus 2 degrees. See, you cannot obtain negative value. If you have obtained negative value, you have to add 360 to it. This indicates the angle is being measured and in anti-clockwise direction. So you have to add this. So you have to add 360 to this. You will get 358 degrees since it is measured in clockwise direction. This is our required magnetic bearing. So from angle between this magnetic meridian to this survey line is 358 degrees. This is the solution obtained. Okay, these are some of the problems based on declination. Fine. Thank you.